Yeah, we'll be okay, Pete. So, take off nice and sedate. Okay. Basically, we just gently accelerate behind the tug.
Yeah.
We'll take off slightly before him.
Yeah.
So we'll just maintain a steady height above the ground, and when he takes off, then we just basically follow him.
Okay.
Three thousand overhead, John.
Yes, please. And we're just waiting for him, and then he's airborne.
Oh, you do fly my wind, do you?
Yeah. Talking about it, but then what we do to pupils before they go solo, we actually test them by pulling the release now.
Obviously,
yeah, bang on 55 knots.
Clear again, it's very broken.
5 knots. And we make them actually practice.
Yeah.
So.
I'm doing exactly 70 miles an hour.
He was reading 65 knots.
Well, I've never had a rope break, and I've never known anyone who has had a rope break.
No.
But as I say, we still practice it, yeah, just in case. In theory, you should never get a rope break because there's weak links each end of the rope.
Okay.
We've got a slightly weaker one than the tug. So if anything goes wrong and we snatch the rope,
yeah,
that weak link should break. It should break at our ends first. And then you would just land as normal and he would land as normal. So you like taking, oh there he is, you mainly take pictures of aeroplanes, do you? Okay. You actually work for the RAF, do you?
No,
right.
They're all about public diving,
yeah. Okay. Do you get to go up with them?
Right. And as much as you can, they're getting all the civilians to step over there, all of you. So I used to get a bunch of tanking ships, but that's definitely good. The civilians to run the tanking.
Yeah. I mean, they've just announced they're putting all SC rescue on, aren't they?
Yeah, so it's a really good job there.
Well, they've waited till Prince William's finished his his tour of duty before they get rid of him.
Looking at on your instrument now then,
please. I'm following him, so basically whatever he's doing I'm doing at the moment until we get off. So I'm keeping an eye on the altimeter just to see what height we're at. You know, we're just going through 2000 at the moment. Everything else I'm relying on him. I mean, if we start going too slow I'll feel it, because the glider won't, you know, just won't be flying. But at the moment 100% looking at him.
Okay.
If you take your eyes off him for just a few seconds, you can be out of position before you know it. It's,
Is there a setback
then
that he's taking?
No. When he takes off, he'll do a circuit of the airfield.
Yeah.
That way, if anything does happen to either me or him, we're over the airfield.
Right.
You'd never take off and go straight out to sea, for example.
Right.
But as soon as we've done that circuit, it just depends on the day and what we've asked for. So I've just asked him to drop us off at 3,000 feet over the airfield, so that's basically what he'll do. We probably annoy the town, but we tend to, if we've got visitors, we tend to fly them over the town if we can. They've got something to look at and a bit more of a view. And if they live in Barrow as well, they can look down at their house. So. But again, that depends on the weather conditions. It's a nice day today. It's nice and clear.
Yeah.
Little bit of haze in the distance, but you can make out the Isle of Man quite clear about 2 o'clock. Just the hills there. On a really clear day from here, you can see Scotland, Isle of Man, and Snowdon. It's great.
Did he contact you?
I let go of him. You see the yellow knob that's just to the left on the front?
Yeah.
Basically, we pull that when we're ready, and he'll feel that. He'll feel the glider let go, and then he'll. Usually we just push forward and turn right slightly, and the glider will pull back and turn left slightly. Then we get separation as quick as we can. So you can see the altimeter's at 3,000 feet now.
Yeah.
So we pull the release like that, we see the rope's gone, and there we go. So what we do now is we just trim the glider. We can slow down a little bit now. We don't need to fly as fast as we do, because we're flying basically at his speed. So that's it now. I mean, I've literally let go of the controls. I'm not doing anything. And we're just flying along nicely. So it's just basically, it's just doing it itself. It's just trimmed out and not doing anything. You know, I'm just let go. It's a nice smooth day today, so we can do that. If we had turbulence, the plane would be, we'd have to keep fighting the turbulence. But, would you like to have a fly?
Yeah.
Okay, so left or right-handed? Okay, just gently, just take hold of the stick. You don't have to death grip it, just nice and gently. What I'm going to do, just to prove it to you, just ease the stick forward a little bit. Don't be frightened of it, yeah. Just pull it back a bit. Yeah, you don't have to move it much. You don't have to put a lot of effort in, do you? I mean, I can literally fly it thumb and little finger if I want to. It's that delicate, you know. So what we do now is, if you look at the airspeed indicator, top right-hand instrument, it's about, what is it, 42, 43, something like that. So, if you look at where the horizon is on reference to the top of the canopy there, if we keep that picture, we'll keep a constant speed, okay? So if we want to speed up, what we do is we ease the stick forward. You see the nose has dropped. More view there, isn't there? Look at your airspeed, it's increasing. So to slow down, we use the stick back just till the horizon disappears. Watch the airspeed. When it's at 42, 43, let it drop, check it. Check it about that picture that we had before. Wait a few seconds and you'll notice we're back at 42, 43 knots. So that's how we control our speed. We mainly do it looking at the horizon, not the instrument.
Okay.
Do you want to try that without me?
I'll have a go.
Go on then.
Forward.
Just ease forward. Don't be front. You may have to push it a little bit. Don't worry about that. As we pick up speed, you'll have to push it a little bit more. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. Yeah. See, we're building up speed.
Yeah.
That's it. Now just gently ease it back. You see a little bit more. That's it. Hold it there so you can see the horizon's disappeared.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now
yeah.
Let it drop and check it there. Back a little bit. Back a bit. That's it. And if you look at that, you've got the same picture you had before, haven't you?
Yeah, yeah.
And if you can maintain that picture, have a look at your airspeed. Look at that, 43, 44 knots, spot on. So basically, that's it. That's how we control our speed.
Right.
Yeah? Do you want to try a turn?
Go ahead, yeah.
Okay, so we'll turn to the right. So first thing we do is we look to the right. Yeah. Make sure it's clear. See yeah. anything?
No. Nope.
So we move the stick and the rudder to the right. Are your feet on the rudder pedals? Okay, so we move the stick and the rudder to the right like that, and the glider rolls. Then when it's about there, we put the stick and the rudder back to the middle. Watch your horizon, yeah? Make adjustments if you need to. Keep that picture as you come round, and look at your speed, yeah? Nice and steady, yeah? And when we want to roll out the turn, we move the stick and the rudder to the left. When the wings are level, stick and rudder back to the middle. Have a look at the horizon again. Have a quick look at your speed, yeah?
Okay.
And again, nice steady 43, 44-ish. Do you want to try that? Okay, we'll turn to the right again. So okay. If you look to the right, clear?
Yeah.
Okay, stick and rudder to the right. A little bit more rudder, push for that right rudder. That's it. And then everything back to the middle. Hold it there, and whilst you hold it there, we'll still go around. Look over the nose, you see, you've still got that picture.
Yeah.
And you've got a nice speed, that's lovely. So if you roll it out, so stick and rudder to the left. Watch the picture, that's it. Yeah, and everything back to the middle again, now we're level. And hold it, just wait for everything to stabilise out. Have a look at the picture. We've got the same picture, have a look at our speed. Spot on. You're a natural, you'll be taking over Graham's job. Right. Shall we try a loop?
Yeah.
Okay. What we'll do, basically we'll point it back at the airfield, it gives us a bit of a reference.
Right.
So what we're going to do, just to let you know so you're ready for it,
yep.
We're going to stick the nose down and pick up some speed.
Okay.
We need to pick up speed, so when we pull the nose back up, it's got enough energy to go over the top.
Right.
Okay, so don't be alarmed if we start picking up speed.
Right.
When we get to about 90, 95 knots, then I'll let you know beforehand, I'm going to pull back. You will feel some positive G as in being pushed into your seat.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
So are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so we stick the nose down.
Okay.
And we wait for the airspeed indicator. You see it's reading 60.
Yeah.
It's reading 70. It's reading 80. Reading 90. Reading 95. And here we go! Negative G. Yeah?
Yeah.
And then we'll just lift the nose up, slow the glider down again. So there we go, that was a loop.
Oh, yeah. Brilliant.
Did you feel the positive?
Oh, yeah.
You're feeling, and then afterwards, did you feel the negative? You're lifting up in your seat,
yeah,
aren't you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Positive, a lot of people don't mind. Negative is the horrible one.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. One loop.
Oh. Well, I've just done the typhoon out in Malaysia. I've just going that around, not with something else, but I've never done that like that.
Well, just let you stabilise down again now, let the blood go back to where it should do. Do you want to have another fly?
Yeah.
Okay, so you have control again now. So okay. If you look at the altimeter, we're at 2,000 feet now, so we've still got plenty of height.
Right.
So, do you want to do another turn?
Yeah. We'll
okay, well, we'll unwind this time. We wound right last time, so we'll unwind. We'll go left.
Yeah.
So if you look to the left, make sure it's clear.
Okay.
Okay, so stick and rudder to the left. A little bit more rudder. Did you feel that? That was horrible. That's because we didn't use rudder.
Right.
That's it. Now, when you're in the bank, everything back to the middle. Watch that horizon. Quick look to the left, make sure it's still clear. Quick over the nose again. Have you got that picture? Yeah. And then rolling out there, yeah. And then back to the middle. just get that picture back and quick check of your speed. Yeah, it's all right, just a tad low, but it's well okay. If you want to speed up a little bit, just let the nose drop sort of like an inch and then hold it again, check it again. So you've just lowered the nose very slightly on the horizon. It picks up, there you go, you see, you've got speed back. So it doesn't take much of an adjustment, but you do have to wait. It's not like a car where you sort of like, you know, you put your foot down and it's there. With this, although you're going faster, the instrument just takes a few seconds to respond to it. That's why you can't control your speed with your airspeed indicator. It's too laggy. Well, if you fly too slow, for example, I'll show you what happens. This is a training glider, so it's very benign. But if we lift the nose up like that, and I keep pulling the nose up, you feel it? That's basically now saying, oi, you're flying too slow. Some gliders, if you do that, they react quite strongly. This one doesn't. It is an easy glider to fly. It's because it's a training glider. But if you do that with a little bit more height, a higher up nose attitude, then you feel it a bit more then, don't you? See, it's dropping. I can't pull it up. So what you do is you stick the nose forward, get your speed, and then back to normal flying again. No matter what I did then, I couldn't lift the nose, it just wanted to drop. And that's what they're designed to do. They're designed the nose to drop. You don't want it that the tail's heavy and the tail drops, that's bad. So it helps you out in a way. The nose drops, you pick up speed and you start flying again. No, they don't. You know, we lost a couple hundred feet doing those stalls then, but we'd have been coming down anyway. So, you want to do the practice competition finish? Okay. It's good fun. This is where this glider's got a maximum speed of 151 knots, which you're talking about, I don't know, 170 mile an hour.
Yeah.
In a dive. So basically what we do is, if we're going to do a practice competition finish, we're going to land on the runway we took off from, but what we'll do is we'll do a, like we're going to do the loop, but we don't pull up into a loop, we just get some speed up. Be good fun. Even I enjoy doing that.
I always imagine that once you've lost it, I mean, you probably
Yeah, you do. We've got that much speed. We were doing about 140 knots there, so you're doing about 155 mile an hour.
Right.
So you know you've got plenty of energy.
Yeah. Absolutely tremendous.
Good. Glad you enjoyed it, because I enjoyed it as well.
Really, really good, yeah. That was something else. That really was.